Hey there, you're watching Amitha Verma. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I just finished a huge renovation to my shop in Houston. It looks amazing, and it looks like it's been transformed from worn down and run down to something fresh and inspiring. And I wanted to let you in today on one of my biggest, most transformative tools. I would say the one thing that took my shop from looking tired and outdated to fresh and inspiring. It is paint. I love it so much. I even created a product line all about paint. I love it because you're able to take something that may not look amazing and transform it into something beautiful. So today I wanted to share with you a couple of strategies that you can implement in your home right away. How I choose paint colors, why I choose the colors that I do, and some of the trends that I tend to stay away from when I'm selecting paint colors in any of my design projects. Often people think selecting the paint color that you're gonna put in your home is the first step to your home makeover. Whenever I'm working on my own home, clients' homes, or even a shop renovation like I recently did, selecting the paint color is the last, very last step that I take in a project. So take, for example, the room that I'm in right now. This is my dining room at home. And you can see there's a lot of commonality in the tones. I've got this really beautiful blue-gray painted finish on my dining chairs, this beautiful blue silk, the gray tones in my dining table, the gray tones on my stone floors, some of the similar tones that you're seeing in the artwork behind me, in the buffet, in the antique Trumeau mirror in my dining room. So those were the items that I took my color cues from to select the right hue for my room. The first thing you need to do, really the only thing you need to do, is to look at all of those things and see what is in common. And you're probably thinking, no, there's nothing in common, but us human beings, we tend to love what we love. So I bet there's something in common. It could be warm tones, gray tones, beige tones, pink tones, blue tones. Whatever that is going to help you decide the lane that you're gonna go down to select the right color for you. So one of my favorite strategies when I'm selecting a paint color is to stay on the lighter side of the color palette. You know, it starts from light to dark, and whenever I'm working on an entire room or an entire home, for me, the paint color is secondary to my fabrics, all my beautiful wood finishes, the stonework, all the beautiful antiques and artwork that I love to look for and include in every single project. I love to look for colors that tend to be in those top two or three groupings of a color chart. So that way, I know it's very calming and soothing and just the perfect subtle backdrop for the rooms I'm designing. So let me show you what I'm talking about. When you go to your paint shop, you're gonna see a very similar idea to this paint deck right here. If you're working with a lot of beige, and that is what's gonna be very cohesive and tie all of your home decor and furniture together, you can see you're gonna pretty much ignore all of this. You're not gonna go to the gray side because that's not gonna go complement your home. You're gonna come over here and then follow the exact same exercise. You can see these are a little bit cooler and tend to go a little bit towards more of the blue tones and olive greens. And then we start getting closer to the red and orange side of the beige. So you can start to see, well, what really matches with the beige tones that I've got in my home? It's either gonna be in here or it's gonna be in here. It's not gonna be both. Once you've found that section, you can start to experiment with the colors just in here to land on that perfect color. Whenever I'm selecting a paint color, I always look to the feeling that I am trying to accomplish. When I tend to stick to the monochromatic color palette, meaning the colors in the room and on the wall tend to look similar, that helps create a very calming, very soothing environment. Our eyes are very used to seeing blue in the sky and green in nature all around us. So these tend to be calming and soothing colors that you might often see in public spaces, or if you have a room that you're trying to create that feeling, you can use these colors in as well. I know you may love some of these tips, but you really just want it straight. What are the colors that I should be using? Well, I have a wonderful treat for you this week. Head over to my blog where you can receive your free downloadable worksheet with some of my favorite paint colors, the ones I use on my projects over and over again. But before you do that, I wanted to share a couple of things I tend to stay away from, or some of the tricks that I use to make sure that when I give a room a paint makeover, it looks all encompassing. Whenever I'm painting my walls and my trim color, my ceiling color, I tend to go for very low contrast, meaning I'm not gonna paint my walls gray and then my trim white. The trim, the ceilings, the windows, the doors, they tend to be a lighter shade of the main color that I'm using. This is because the furniture, the antiques, the decor, these pieces are the star of the show. So I want my walls to have very little contrast and be that perfect backdrop. Another frequently asked question that we get is, what level of sheen should I use on my wall paint? Again, taking into account the style that we design it, it tends to be very old, worn, and weathered. So I tend to stick with a flat finish or at most a satin finish, and nothing more than that on the design projects we work on. Another tip I would recommend to you is to stay away from pure white or all white. I do love using white, but sometimes it can feel a little bit cold and a little bit impersonal. So the way I add that warmth and that welcoming, cozy feeling back into my color palettes is to look for whites with a hint of blue, green, cream, a little bit of softness to take that bright white down to a more relatable color palette. And last but not least, I truly love to keep it classic. Something that's gonna stay a good choice, a good selection for the next 10 years or more. So for that reason, I tend to stay away from a lot of the fads that come and go with paint. Things like sparkle or even an accent wall. And I know this may be a hot button issue. You can leave a comment and let me know if you love them or leave them. But if you love a color enough to make it an accent wall, my tip for you is to go all out. I actually did this in a room in our home. We decided to turn it into a library, family room, media room, where we could house all of our books and enjoy spending time together as a family in this room. Rather than going small, I put my money where my mouth is and painted every single one of these bookshelves blue. So don't be shy, don't be afraid to take the leap. Skip that accent wall and go all out. Leave a comment and let me know your thoughts. And of course, if you have any questions, leave that in the comment section as well. And if you're completely confused and have no idea where to start, don't forget to head over to my website where you can receive your free downloadable worksheet with some of my most tried and true paint colors to shortcut your way to making over your own room or home today. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. That helps me know that you love this type of content and find it helpful. Then hit the subscribe or follow button and be sure to ring the bell so you don't miss another one of our inspiring episodes. After that, head over to my blog where you can sign up to receive your design newsletter and soak in endless hours of amazing design tips. Till the next time we meet, keep making your home amazing with your design gifts.
Okay, and test.
Hey there, you're watching Amitha Verma. Test number two. I'm gonna be using my hands, and this shirt is like a little more slinky. And come over here and like. Now, what is that one thing? It is, let me say, what is that one thing? My favorite tool, it's paint. Okay. Head over to my blog where you can receive your free downloadable worksheet. Okay.
Action.
Are we doing the outro?
Yes.
Okay.